Is scuba diving risky? Humans are not designed to breathe underwater, which means that a diver is totally dependent upon the safety equipment, skills, and emergency training to guarantee a safe resurface for every dive. While it may sound frightening, do not be discouraged. Where is the glory without risk? However, you might run into this while you're down there. Shipwrecks, sharks, and spaceships. Wait, chicken monsters? Just you wait. Here are 15 mysterious things that nearly stopped divers' hearts.
The components that Bezos Expeditions raised from the bottom of the Atlantic in 2013. So.
Number 15. Sagami Bay Creature. Cameras aboard the Hyper Dolphin Rove captured footage of something strange lurking on the ocean floor of Sagami Bay, southwest of Tokyo. Sounds exciting, right? We assume that's why we send these incredible technological advanced robot operating vehicles to the deepest parts of our oceans, to find strange things. But what the heck is it? These waters, centered chiefly on sandy shores, extend from Inoshimi and Sagami Bay to Manazuru Cape. At the mouth of the Sagami River are found the only tidal mud flats, important settlement grounds for animals on tidal mud flats in the bay. Beasts like the megamouth shark, small-toothed sand tiger, frilled shark, goblin shark, bowmouth, guitar fish, whale shark, and others appear with some frequency. But again, doesn't explain this. Is it even alive? Suspended in its ocean grave, perfectly preserved by the elements. Some say it's the mythical Ninjin, an aquatic humanoid creature reported to inhabit sub-Antarctic oceans. The word in Japanese means human. It's commonly considered to be a cryptid, a mysterious animal whose existence or survival is disrupted or unsubstantiated. Now, let's get ready for today's open discussion. It's not known who first braved cold, dark waters and held their breath to explore or gather rare treasures or food. The Mesopotamians retrieved pearls from oysters as early as 4,500 years ago. The Greeks, too, traded in pearls and sea sponges, and the Chinese are said to have followed soon after. There are multiple wonders in the ocean, but what is it about the sea that moves you the most? Is it ferocious animal attacks or epic schools of swirling fish? Maybe it's the migration of whale families or the discovery of hidden treasures buried underwater. Make sure to comment, let us know your favorite ocean phenomenon below, and use the hashtag #OpenDiscussion. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14. Underwater shark volcano. Several species of shark, ranging from reef sharks, hammerheads, and scalloped hammerheads, make regular appearances in one of the world's most active submarine volcanoes. The shocking discovery was made in 2015 at the Solomon Islands Kavachi volcano, a real-life sharkano. Kavachi is one of the most active submarine volcanoes in the Southwest Pacific Ocean. Located south of Vangunu Island in the Solomon Islands, it's named after a sea god of the New Georgia Group Islanders and is also referred to locally as Reihote Kavachi. Scientists were shocked to find not just life but large carnivores circling its turbulent base. After dropping video cameras, bait, and lights, an instrument package called a drop cam into the deep sea of the Solomon Islands as part of their volcanic work. The idea of there being large animals like sharks hanging out and living inside this volcano conflicts with what experts know about the Kavachi volcano, which is that it erupts. Exactly why sharks inhabit the Kavachi volcano remains one of the world's enduring marine mysteries. Scientists believe the sharks must have mutations that let them thrive in the harsh environment. Number 13. Deepsteria enigmatica. The internet swears it's a whale placenta. What other reasonable explanation for the underwater video that popped up of a dancing curtain of flesh? They call it Deepsteria enigmatica, a very rarely seen giant jellyfish. One of the ocean's more mysterious jellyfish has been difficult to study because of its natural habitat in the dark depths of the ocean. But technology is opening up those depths to our curious eyes, which recently led to a 10-minute encounter with the peculiar, tentacle-less Deepsteria enigmatica. The bell of this jellyfish is very thin and wide, up to 2 feet, and resembles a translucent, undulating sheet or lava lamp as the animal moves. They're usually found in Antarctic and near Antarctic seas, but have been spotted in waters near the United Kingdom too. Its bell is large, and it's been hypothesized that D. enigmatica is an ambush predator that uses its entire bell membrane to catch upward-moving prey, closing around it like a bag. During their encounter, the team was able to observe what this might look like. Unless you're examining it up close, the enigmatica looks a lot like a plastic bag with a delicate, thin bell and no visible tentacles. Deepsteria has to rely on another method. Number 12. Apollo 11 engines discovered. Amazon.com founder and space entrepreneur Jeff Bezos loves to explore the depths. Bezos wanted to recover the F1 engines that powered the Saturn V rocket that blasted the Apollo 11 moon landing mission into orbit in 1969. The engines, which were ejected from the Saturn V rocket as Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin shot into orbit, were found 14,000 feet below the ocean surface off the coast of Florida. Unfortunately, Bezos says, the original serial numbers are partially missing, meaning that we may never know for sure that these are from Apollo 11. Nevertheless, there are enough recovered components found using radar and remotely operated deep-sea vehicles to piece together two complete engines. The internet retail mogul might seem an unusual patron of Apollo 11 artifacts in history, but Bezos says he was inspired to dream big by watching the original moon mission as a 5-year-old in 1969. So the Amazon chief and his team of researchers discovered the giant rocket engines in what he described as an underwater wonderland, an incredible sculpture garden of twisted F1 engines. Number 11. Underwater mystery circles. You've seen crop circles on land, but what about underwater? And is it also extraterrestrial aliens responsible for the ocean phenomenon? Beneath the waters that surround the Amami Oshima Island in Japan, a tiny artist is gathering fine sand to create a patterned circle for an elaborate mating ritual. The recently discovered white-spotted pufferfish builds underwater crop circles in order to attract a mate, which also doubles as protection for the female's eggs. The white-spotted pufferfish spends at least 6 weeks building a patterned mating circle that's 20 times its size. It moves around in a circle, gathering up fine sand and adorns the fished structure with sand dollars and seashells. Once the design is finished, a female will swim into the center to signal approval, and the male bites on her cheek to start the mating process. After the underwater circles were discovered, researchers began to monitor the seabed with the hopes of uncovering the mystery. And within a year, the team found their answer. The fish spends about 6 weeks building the structure that is 20 times its size, which also acts as a way to slow down the current in order to protect the eggs. Number 10. The Ghost Fleet of Truck Lagoon. South Pacific's Caroline Islands harbor the Ghost Fleet of Truck Lagoon. The islands were once part of the Spanish West Indies, explored by Magellan and later visited by Spanish merchants and missionaries. The low coral islands are surrounded by a remarkable sheltered reef, ideal for housing a navy. In a surprise attack by American allies in World War II, approximately 250 aircrafts were destroyed and more than 50 ships sunk. And most of the fleet remains in exactly the same spot it was left, largely forgotten by the world until the late 1960s. As wreck divers brought attention to the site, Japan began recovery efforts, and many bodies were removed and returned to Japan for burial. A few, however, remain. Many of the wrecks are visible through the shallow, clear water, making it an accessible dive. The wrecks themselves can be very dangerous, not only because of ragged edges and tangles of cables, but because of half-century-old oil and fuel leaking into the water, creating a potentially dangerous situation. Jacques Cousteau's famous 1969 film, Lagoon of Lost Ships, explores the wreck-littered lagoon, and many of the sunken ships were then still full of bodies. Number 9. Giant Barrel Jellyfish. A couple lucky ocean enthusiasts had been diving for about a half an hour when a single enormous jellyfish, unlike any they'd ever seen before, emerged out of the murky water. The pair spent the next hour or so swimming alongside the unusual specimen, recording footage while they swam. A barrel jellyfish, the largest of their kind in the UK. Reflecting on the week-long expedition, the lucky diver spotted animals ranging from seals to breaching mink whales, lunge-feeding whales, dolphins, and finally, the giant jellyfish. The animals boast 8 frilly arms equipped with stinging tentacles and typically grow to lengths of about 3 feet. Few humans meet members of this species in their natural habitat. Instead, most people encounter the marine animals when they wash up on beaches. Thousands of the creatures, the largest jellyfish found in British coastal waters, flock through the Atlantic Ocean towards warm coastal waters in the west of the UK each year and are often found washed up on beaches across May and June. It has a very mild sting and poses no threat to humans. In fact, some people don't even feel the animal's sting. Number 8. Headless Chicken Monster. This monster is a strange, pinkish-red creature with a body like a plump-breasted and decapitated chicken, earning the creature the name Headless Chicken Monster. In truth, it's the swimming sea cucumber, and scientists recently captured video of this bizarre, hen-mimicking swimmer in the Southern Ocean near eastern Antarctica, where it's never been seen before. The chicken monster has been caught on film only once before, last year in the Gulf of Mexico. The researchers used new camera technology to detect the swimming sea cucumber at a depth of about 9,800 feet below sea level. On average, they measure between 2 and 8 inches. Adults' colors can range from dark reddish-brown to crimson, though juveniles are typically a pale shade of pink. But unlike most sea cucumbers, the headless chicken monster has fins, which allow it to swim upward to escape predators. While most types of sea cucumbers spend the majority of their time on the seabed, swimming sea cucumbers like the headless chicken monster, aka the swimming sea cucumber, land only to feed. Now, it might look like a headless hen, but we're guessing that it doesn't taste like chicken. Number 7. Giant Pyrosomes. Shocked divers found themselves dwarfed by a monster deep sea worm, measuring more than 26 feet long and looking just like a giant windsock off the coast of Waikari. They were swimming in a stratovolcano in New Zealand when they discovered the gelatinous worm. Initially diving to record footage for the island, their focus was stolen by the hollow creature. The worm can be seen moving delicately through the water, occasionally shuddering and pulsating while the divers swim gently around it, so not to disturb it. These giant glowing sea worms aren't actually worms though, they're pyrosomes, free-floating bodies made up of multiple tiny bodies to create one big body, like the giant sea worm. They're the Borg of the sea. One long pyrosome is actually a collection of thousands of clones, with each individual capable of copying itself and adding to the colony. And unlike members of the Borg, which are mentally connected, pyrosome members are physically connected, actually sharing tissues. And while the Borg live in a big scary ship, pyrosomes are the big scary ship. The whole colony is shaped like a giant thimble with a point on one end and an opening on the other. And in some species, this opening can be up to 6 feet wide, large enough to fit a full-grown human inside. Number 6. The world's deepest freedive. Freediving is one of the oldest forms of diving and involves divers diving as deep as they can dive on one breath of air. There are only 4 freedivers in the world who have dived beyond 560 feet, and 2 have died trying. Nitch is the world's only diver so far to have gone beyond. Way beyond. Herbert Nitsch is named as the deepest man on Earth, and for a very good reason. In 2012, in the waters of Santorini, Greece, following extensive training, he managed to reach a depth of 831 feet. But 10 minutes after the dive, he began experiencing serious symptoms of decompression sickness. Following a planned post-dive decompression, he signaled to a support team that he felt much weaker than normal. His condition was assessed as critical enough to require an air transfer to a pre-alerted decompression chamber in Athens. Plus, he had multiple brain strokes due to severe decompression sickness. The initial prognosis was that he would need home care and be unable to walk without a wheelchair. However, through extensive rehabilitation, he made a strong recovery. He still has balance and coordination problems on land, but does not experience them underwater, and he continues to deep free dive. Number 5. The Piglet Squid. scientists released a video of a strange critter, the piglet squid, floating along with its tentacles waving above its head in the central Pacific Ocean, about 4,544 feet below the ocean surface. "What are you?" one of the voices in the video can be heard asking as the small creature comes into view. "Is that a squid? I think it's a squid. It's like a bloated squid with tiny tentacles and a little hat that's waving around, and it looks like it's got a massive, inflated mantle cavity. I've never seen anything quite like this before." That's an accurate description of the piglet squid, which is also known for its siphon that looks a bit like the nose of a young pig. Piglet squids, like all cephalopods, have radically different bodies from animals of all kinds that we're used to seeing on land. Instead of having their limbs and head all connected to a central organ-holding body, their body, or mantle, and limbs stick out of a central head. While the piglet squid was actually discovered in 1907 and isn't a new species, this is one of the rarer up-close looks at the ocean dweller. It isn't often that researchers are able to photograph it, and it certainly painted a majestic and unique picture for Nautilus staff to observe. Number 4. Christ of the Abyss Statue. While icons of the divine and decorations abound in densely populated areas, rarely do you see honored artistry in the middle of nowhere. The original Christ of the Abyss is immersed in the waters of San Fruttuoso, not far from the worldwide renowned village of Portofino. Located more than 50 feet under the sea, the bronze statue was placed on the seabed on the 22nd of August in 1954 at the initiative of legendary Italian diver Duilio Morcante, who wanted to place a statue of Jesus following the death of his friend, which occurred during a dive a few years earlier in that spot. Similar statues have been placed underwater and above ground all over the world, some as an homage to the original, others as more just mere copycats. The original clay statue from which this first sculpture was cast is now in Ravenna, Italy's National Museum of Underwater Activities. The sculpture is 8 feet high and it weighs almost 600 pounds. It's been recently restored to preserve it from corrosion and to reattach the hand that's been detached by the anchor. The Christ of the Abyss has become a tourist destination for scuba divers around the world. Number 3. The Baltic Sea Anomaly. A feature on the floor of the Baltic Sea that was discovered by Swedish treasure hunters is making headlines once again. The Baltic Sea Anomaly, one of the more bizarre deep-sea finds of the past decade. The discovery occurred in 2011 when a deep-sea exploration team called Ocean X came across an unusual formation 300 feet below the surface, off the coast of Sweden. They quickly picked up on the anomaly due to its circular shape and distinctively straight protrusions. Adding to the mystery was what appeared to be an extensive trail, which some speculated could be evidence that a crash landing may have taken place. But a Stockholm University geologist studied a few rocks the divers picked up from the site, and there wasn't a single alien life form among them. Instead, there were mostly regular stones that everyone would expect from the kind of glacial basin the Baltic Sea fills. But most experts agree that the structure is probably nothing close to man-made. No doubt, the site has intrigued conspiracy hunters since it was discovered, with inexplicable technical problems plaguing anyone who tries to investigate. The object could be at least 140,000 years old. Number 2. The San Jose Shipwreck. This isn't just a hidden treasure, it's a huge, very controversial treasure. It was 1708 when the Spanish galleon San Jose erupted into flames off the coast of Cartagena, Colombia. The ship had been at battle with the British since late afternoon, and by night, the 62-cannon galleon had disappeared into the Caribbean Sea. With it, sunk nearly 600 people and up to millions of dollars worth of gold, silver, and jewels. For centuries, the San Jose galleon lay lost on the ocean floor, but the mystery surrounding the ship began to unravel in 2015 when the Colombian government announced it had officially been found. Now it's at the center of custody disputes among parties all staking claim to the San Jose's riches. The Colombian government hasn't revealed the exact location of the famed galleon, which is often called the Holy Grail of shipwrecks. In fact, the real-life treasure ship has long been the subject of fascinations. Nobel Prize-winning author Gabriel Garcia Marquez wrote about the galleon in Love in the Time of Cholera. The novel's main character, Florentino Ariza, plan to dive down and retrieve the San Jose's riches for his lifelong love. Number 1. The Yonaguni Monument. And last but not least, Yonaguni-jima is an island that lies near the southern tip of Japan's Ryukyu Archipelago, about 75 miles off the eastern coast of Taiwan. A local diver first noticed the Yonaguni formations in 1987, something underwater that was far more interesting than the hammerhead sharks that swam there. The submerged stone structures lying just below the waters off Yonaguni-jima are actually the ruins of a Japanese Atlantis, an ancient city sunk by an earthquake about 2,000 years ago. Geologists believe that it's most likely natural. The sandstones that make up the Yonaguni formation to contain numerous well-defined parallel bedding planes along which the layers easily separate. The rocks of this group are also crisscrossed by numerous sets of parallel, vertically oriented joints in the rock. These joints are natural parallel fractures by which the rectangular formation seen in the area likely formed. Yonaguni lies in an earthquake-prone region, so geology and strong currents may explain the peculiar shape of the rock, but they cannot account for the pottery, stone tools, and fireplaces found there, possibly dating back to 2500 BCE. Those were 15 mysterious things that nearly stopped divers' hearts. Thanks for watching.